Well, after nearly 100 years, Land O'Lakes is changing course on its image that it has used for its brand. That image is that of a Native American woman. Over time, many have spoken out about it, saying it's a problem, saying it's disrespectful to Native women, saying it is a stereotype. But one Native man has a unique view on this, so unique that the Washington Post asked him to write about his feelings in an editorial.
Robert DesJarlait has something to say.
My Ojibwe father drew a Land O'Lakes maiden. She was never a stereotype.
Yes, Robert's father, Patrick, was the one who reimagined the image you're so used to seeing, known as Mia, on your butter box. He did it in 1954.
So with the dress she was wearing, he added the Ojibwe floral beadwork to it. The other thing he added was in the background, he drew her right before a lake, and in the background there's two points of land. That's actually a familiar feature up in Red Lake.
Red Lake Nation is where the family lived until Robert was around 8. It was and is a place Robert says his family is proud to be a part of, and he thinks a place that was proud to be a part of them.
But you know, people up in Red Lake are very proud that one of their own, so to speak, had a made these accomplishments in art.
When your father created or recreated this image, was it a source of pride?
Oh, definitely.
But over time, the image began to be scrutinized in the same company of criticism that some had and have for Native imagery being used as mascots or logos. Robert knows that issue well, as he was one of the criticizers.
I mean, I've been involved in the anti-mascot movement since the 1990s. I was at the protest we had at the World Series in 91. I was at the Super Bowl game in 92. I also wrote a booklet for an Oskahanapan Indian education program about stereotypes.
So with that kind of background, one where he takes issue with that football team in Washington's name, or that baseball team in Atlantis, how can Robert not take issue with the image his father recreated?
What I usually like to say is that she devolved into a stereotype. She didn't begin that way. But through cultural correctness, political correctness, she became associated with mascots and logos.
He says what he wants people to know is his father didn't intend harm when he reimagined Mia more than 65 years ago.
He would never intentionally create a stereotype because he's very proud of his culture and he used his art to, you know, educate people about their culture.
But intention then and the time we live in now are different, which leaves Robert with a rather interesting point of view.
When I first heard about it, I said, well, I'm glad she's gone. But then I had to think about that. And the more I thought about it, I felt that maybe she didn't have to go. But again, I do understand why people see her as a stereotype.
So you can hold both of those things at once.
Yeah, I think you can, yeah.
It's pretty interesting to sit with that final thought, I think, that there isn't always an absolute right or an absolute wrong. There's room in there for all voices and opinions to be heard. As far as the image for Land O'Lakes, the company isn't saying that much, but according to Adweek, the revised logos will fully replace the image that you're used to seeing by the end of the year.